Hello, my name is Jaap van Milgen. I'm working at INRA in France and I'm the coordinator of the FeedaGene project. FeedaGene is a project funded by the European Commission and it deals with adapting the feed, the animal and the feeding techniques to improve the efficiency and the sustainability of monogastric livestock production systems. FeedaGene has its three words, and the two main words are basically the main disciplines that we're working on in the project. It's about feeding and nutrition and about the genetics. And the word A could mean that we are trying to nourish the gene by nutrition, and in a way we try to do that. But it's much more than that. It's basically the two resources that we are using, the genes, the genetic resource and the feed resource. But how can we combine these? And it's just not the direct link. There are different aspects that we have to address, including feeding techniques, but also the sustainability of livestock production systems. FeedaGene involves many partners. In total, 23 partners are in the project. They come from different countries, Denmark, the UK, the Netherlands, France, Spain, Switzerland, Italy, Hungary and China, and they all have different expertise and knowledge in areas, so the partitioning of different tasks varies depending on the country. The interaction among work packages is something very important. We have six different, I'd say, scientific work packages. There's one work package dealing with new traits that are indicative of feed efficiency or robustness of the animal or of livestock production systems. And these indicators of efficiency can be used, for instance, in animal breeding programs. And that is one example of an interaction between two of the six work packages, the scientific work packages and FeedaGene. Another one is where we develop models of nutrient use. How do animals use nutrients? How do animals vary in the use of nutrients? And this is also an aspect that we are using in precision livestock farming feed systems and farming systems, which is another work package of the FeedaGene project. The EU, well, in a broad sense, they wanted to make better use of natural resources. They asked for new techniques related to feeding, related to genetics, related to potential innovation capacities, new technologies. And they also wanted to have, which is very important, they also wanted to have stakeholder implication, and end-user implication in the project. So FeedaGene involves many different partners, academic partners, it involves industry partners, it involves also extension services. We are working on monogastric animals, so most of these production sectors are very industrialized. So part of the results of the FeedaGene project will be taken up by industry, stakeholders that have a direct impact on monogastric livestock production systems. I really hope that at the end of the project and in the years after the project, in the 5 to 10 years after the project, that we can see practices or technological developments being used in the market. FeedaGene is not a project in which we will develop full-fledged solutions. In the European language, or they talk about TRL levels, technology readiness levels. We're going up to level 5, perhaps 6. And to put it to market, it has to go to level 9. So it's up to society at large to pick up the ideas that we initiate, that we develop, and bring it to products that can be used in agriculture in general. The challenge also in the project is that we are dealing with people from different disciplines. One challenge is to try to understand each other, and that the geneticist understands what a people in nutrition is saying, and that a person with expertise in economic science understands the issues that geneticists or engineers come up with. And I think it's really the understanding that is crucial, and as long as people are open-minded, I have no doubt that it will succeed. Personally, the most exciting aspect of the project is working with all these people from different disciplines. It's not specifically any scientific aspects, although I have expertise in a certain domain. For me personally, the most exciting thing is working with people from different disciplines and trying to get them to work together and understand each other.